All right, so we're going to look at the anatomy of a for loop, and the first thing that a for loop will start with is the word for. And the word for is a reserved word. It's a keyword that lets Python know that we are going to create a loop of the type for. Now, for a for loop, we know that we are typically counting things, like counting 1 to 10, or counting down from 10 to 1, or 1 to 5, counting by twos, whatever. There's a lot of different ways that we can do that, right? We can even count things like individual characters in a word. So there's a lot of different things we can do with for loops, but generally it's a fixed loop that we count up or down to a specific value. Right, and so in this case, we have to have something that is a counter that kind of keeps track of things. So if I told you to count to a 100, in your mind, you're holding the number that you would actually be counting to. So if you were got to 53, you know that that's the number you're just on. You kind of are keeping that in your memory as you then go to 54 and 55 and so on. You know how to go to the next number because you kind of keep that last number in your mind. That's essentially what this I is that's gonna we're gonna see here. So the variable I is what we're going to use as a counter variable. This is also known as a local or private variable, meaning that it's something that's used only for the loop and then it's thrown away. So you'll notice that we're not using an actual, good naming convention with this. Like we aren't calling this count or something like that, although we could. It's just not convention or style to do that because the variable is literally only used for the loop and then it's gotten rid of. And so because it's that case, because it's that private or local variable, we just name it I. Again, that's just style and convention. You could name it A, you could name it Z, it's whatever you want to name it. And you could actually call it count if that makes you happier and makes it easier for you to understand what's going on. So now that we have this counter variable that is going to keep track of where we are in our loop, then we want to say, well, how do we count? Let's say I told you to do 10 push-ups, right? Then I would be telling you the number, the quantity that you're counting to. And in this case, I use the command called range. Now, in means that for all the i's in some range, okay? So you're going to see for and in are always going to be there in that loop, and those things are going to always be required. I and range actually can change. Like I said, you could change it to a different variable name, and we don't have to use range as you'll see in some of the examples that we walk through. So we have in range, and in this range command, we can specify the values that we want I to count through. So in this case, we'll do 1 through 10. Okay, so in parentheses, we have 1 is the starting number, comma, and then 10, the stopping number. Now, we're going to talk about what number actually gets output by this here in a second. So that's something that's going to be a little bit tricky. At the end of this conditional statement, this loops condition that we have, we will have a colon. That lets Python know that, hey, we're getting ready to give you the commands that you need to actually run this loop. And so that's the loop condition there at the very top. The next thing that we will see is the loop body. And the loop body is always indented. So we're going to want either hit the tab key, or if you're in an IDE like PyCharm, it will automatically do that for you. So in this case, we're just going to print out the values of I, right? So we have this loop that goes from 1 to 10 and prints out all the values 1 through 10 as we go. Now you're going to see 10 is actually not included in that, and here's why. So if we were to look at what's going on with this loop, we see that the value of I starts out as 1. And so is 1 in the range of 1 to 10? Well, yes, it is. And so it prints out 1. What's kind of hidden here from us is that I is then automatically what we call incremented. We add 1 to it. So you might remember back in variables, we said I plus equals 1. Then that's the same thing as saying I equals I plus 1. That's what's happening in this for loop automatically for us. They're designed to count up or down, and so it just makes it a little bit easier for us to not have that additional line. So in the for loop, I is automatically incremented. And so we print out 1. We then add 1 to I. It goes back up to the condition, the for, and it says, is 2 in the range of 1 through 10? Well, yes, it is. So you'll see that its output, it's printed. It will then add 1 to it, and then we'll say, is 3 in the range of 1 to 10? Yes, it is. So it'll print out 3. It will continue that process over and over until it gets to 9, right? And so it says, is 9 in the range of 1 to 10? Well, yes, it is. It prints out 9, it adds 1 to it. It then gets to the value of 10. So then it says, is 10 in the range of 1 to 10. Well, in this case, it's not inclusive of the 10, meaning that it doesn't include the 10 in range. And so therefore, it just exits the loop. That is why 10 never gets printed. So your actual output for this is 1 through 9. So just something important to keep in mind with the range command, that it will go up to, but not including the value 10, the second value that we put here inside the parentheses. So that's how a loop looks in Python. In the next video, we're going to look at exactly how to actually type and execute this in a PyCharm Python file.